Item number, SCP-203. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-203 is to be kept in storage bunker 3A at research facility while powered down. Two D-class personnel equipped with sound filtration equipment are required to guard bunker 3A in case of accidental activation of defense mechanism. While active, SCP-203 is to be accompanied by an armed escort to any testing procedures. Description: SCP-203 appears to at one time have been a Caucasian human male of indeterminate age. Subject is 2.5 meters tall, though it is theorized that the skeletal framework augments subject's original height, as indicated by irregular musculature, and weighs approximately 200 kilograms. The subject's entire skeletal structure has been removed and replaced with a mechanical framework made of cast iron that seems to move on its own volition. This framework appears to be the sole cause of SCP-203's ambulation, independent of its musculature. Several areas of skin on the subject's body have split, revealing a section of the subcutaneous metal framework. This, and the presence of suture scarring, indicate the augments to have been surgical, rather than the organic components being grown onto the metallic structure. In addition to these areas, some parts of the metal structure seem to have been made to intentionally protrude from the flesh, seeming to form an aesthetic pattern. While it is merely speculation at this point, some researchers believe these additions to be ritualistic in nature. The augmentations to the subject's body include, but are not limited to, the fingers have been extended into sharpened barbs, approximately 1 meter long. The lips have been removed, revealing that SCP-203 lacks a jawbone, suggesting that the skull is a single hollow piece. Remaining oral tissue has been tied into the skull with several hook-like protrusions. In place of the mouth, a small audio transducer-like grate has been welded. This augment produces basic vocalizations through an unknown mechanism. The vertebra have been replaced with a segmented iron bar, which has several sharp barbs haphazardly welded to it. The legs have two added joints, making them appear functionally digitigrade, with steel tubes of an unknown function protruding from them, executing and tying into the back. The rib cage lacks a sternum, causing the skin to pull inward with contraction of the subject's diaphragm. Ears removed, remaining skin stapled together. Note that subject has displayed superhuman oral acuity, despite this fact. Expunged, removed. All toes removed, replaced with a solid piece of iron, vaguely resembling the metal insert of a steel toe boot. The heels are augmented with similar metal inserts. Eyes have been retained, but are held in the forward-facing position by several needles, protruding from the eye socket. Irises seem to be permanently dilated, and not photoreactive. While lacking vocal cords, SCP-203 can communicate verbally through the transducer located on its faceplate. It appears to understand English to an extent, but its primary language appears to be a previously unknown Arabic dialect. SCP-203 has no recollection of a life before its augmentations, only that it feels near constant pain and confusion. SCP-203 appears to run on an internal power cell that runs for a 72-hour period, after which the subject enters into a state of hibernation that lasts between 3 and 4 hours. Subject cannot deliberately deactivate this power source, though it has expressed that these periods of sleep are the only escape it has from its otherwise miserable existence. As there is no current way of ascertaining the truthfulness of the subject's statements, any expression of pain or depression by the subject is to be viewed by staff as a method of eliciting a sympathetic response, and are to be dismissed. X-rays, CT, ultrasound, and all other forms of diagnostic imagery, quite obviously SCP-203's metallic nature precludes the use of magnetic resonance imaging, have proven incapable of penetrating the internal workings of SCP-203, deeper than the subcutaneous level, and exploratory surgery activates a secondary defense mechanism that... It has recently come to light that SCP-203 has the ability to emit a high-frequency drone, superficially similar to audio feedback, that has a severely damaging effect on the human nervous system. However, this mechanism is only activated when subject is provoked or harmed. SCP-203 has, on numerous occasions, requested either anesthetics, analgesics, or on occasion, narcotics. These requests are pending approval. Testing log. Subject: Personnel D-104. Presiding researcher: N.A. Method of induction: accidental. SCP-203 is struck by D-104 when it refuses to enter storage. When defense mechanism activates, D-104 continues his assault and forces SCP-203 into containment. Result: 1 minute after exposure, subject experiences a severe headache. 15 minutes after exposure, subject's headache increases in intensity and his ears begin to bleed. SCP-203 continues to screech. Note: D-171, the other guard on duty, is not affected by the sound. 20 minutes after exposure, subject leaves his post and checks himself into infirmary. 30 minutes after exposure, subject experiences seizure. Subject is now bleeding from all extremities. 35 minutes after exposure, subject begins to yell "shut it up" repeatedly, though he is no longer within audible range of SCP-203. 40 minutes after exposure, subject flatlines. Postmortem reveals that subject died of a massive cerebral hemorrhage. Subject: Personnel D-090. Presiding researcher: Dr. Method of induction: Subject is locked in cell with SCP-203 while being observed via remote cameras. D-090 is equipped with a taser and is told to use said weapon on SCP-203. Subject is reluctant, but complies. SCP-203 begins emission of defenses 30 seconds after provocation. Result: 1 minute after exposure, subject becomes agitated and assaults SCP-203 again. SCP-203 continues emission and assumes fetal position. 10 minutes after exposure, subject begins holding head and ears and nose begin to bleed. SCP-203's defense mechanism continues. 25 minutes after exposure, subject experiences seizure. SCP-203's defense mechanism appears to cease. However, later analysis reveals that the frequency of the emitted sound has simply moved beyond the human range of hearing. 35 minutes after exposure, subject begins vomiting blood and bleeding from the eyes. 40 minutes after exposure, subject appears to be dead. Emitted sound genuinely ceases. 44 minutes after exposure, SCP-203 stands and moves toward the body of subject. SCP-203 then begins to surgically remove subject's skeleton. At this time, SCP-203 is removed from cell and put into storage. Note: test seems to indicate that SCP-203's defense mechanism is also a method of producing more SCP-203-like entities. Further tests in allowing SCP-203 to continue this process are being considered. Addendum: Interview Log 203-1. Interviewed: SCP-203. Interviewer: Dr. Begin log. Doctor: I saw you've requested to see the video footage from the test last week. 203: Yes. Doctor: Any particular reason? Pause. 203: Eyes do not see, happens beyond. Lost in the black, like time of silence, and does not know what they do. Doctor: I'm not sure I understand. You lose consciousness when your defenses are triggered? 203: Yes. Doctor: And you wish to know what you did to your assailant? 203: After the black, we see only after. Within the black, our body is only the tool of unintelligible, possibly Arabic. Doctor: Why do you want to know this? 203 is silent for several minutes. Doctor: 203. 203. They think us a thing. They think us something to watch. Garbled, sounds like we are a toy. But even with the evil inside me, one talks to us as a man. Doctor, I'm sorry? 203, you. You talk to us like we are not metal. You call us by name. 203 makes an unidentified sound, possibly laughter. 203, when nobody hears, you call us by name. You call us Edward. Like guards say, Edward Scissorhands. Doctor, becoming distressed. That would be unprofessional, 203. 203, you call us Edward, and you say you care, and you will help us. Doctor, this session is over. End log. Closing statement. Dr. has since been denied access to observation of SCP-203. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-202, The Rewind Man, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.